shall ever find the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
The Shea Steph and Rudy house, and going to go do some window shopping, and thought about something that me and Mike Alonso talked about on his channel last night. And I'm gonna have Mike come here when I can. First off, I have an announcement. My other channel is going to be, it's called The Cantina. Live at the Cantina. And I'm going to start doing my live broadcasts once, twice a week from there, depending, with a guest, without a guest. It'll be a StreamYards thing, and I just decided to do something like that, and when that happens, I'm going to put a link for that in this description for that channel so y'all can join. And I'm going to make sure that you guys know when I go live so you can watch and be part of it. But I want to talk a little bit about something we talked about. The three things that Disney's worried about, backlash, once they remove the ST from canon. And they're going to politely ignore it. I would tell them, if you want to get fans back, instead of just acting like the ST didn't happen, I think it would be better in the long run to pull the band-aid off, whoosh, like that. It'll hurt for a minute. Be a lot of internet gas from the usual suspects, the shills and all the rest. And of course the Ray Blows and all the rest of that stuff, but in the end, I really think that if you want the fans back and show good faith, I think an announcement, if you are going to completely reset everything and decanonize the sequel trilogy, I think the best way to do it is to probably announce it so the fans know you really mean what you're doing. Because if you don't do that, I know there's people worried about confusion. You're going to leave more confusion if you don't do that. Pretend it didn't happen. It doesn't work for me. Because people will be like, you know, that's more confusing than just saying, hey, we screwed up. And going forward, we are setting the last 6 years, 8 years of films, books, and everything into legends like you've said you're going to. And we are resetting. We've heard the fans. We understand how upset they are. And the last 8 years, the fans and the actors and the people who are involved with Lucasfilm that didn't like what we were doing, weren't listened to, and now they're being listened to. I mean, that's what I would do. But you have to have guts to do that. And I think right now, in the climate we're in, with all this manufactured uncertainty, I really believe that the best way to do it is literally to pull the band-aid off, announce it, you know, and weather the week of screaming hissy fits. Because I need to tell you something. People that like the sequel trilogy aren't Star Wars fans. They don't understand it. Know what it means. Reylos will be off to the next ugly, pasty-faced, weird-looking dude actor. And, or they'll go back to Twilight. Or whatever. So, you know, I think your best bet's probably to Just announce it. Apologize to the longtime fans. And, you know, admit there were mistakes made. Okay. I also think the investors would appreciate a little bit of transparency and honesty. I think that would help a lot. Maybe not. I'm not going to say I am a Harvard MBA or anything. You're a graduate of the Wharton School of Business, but still, you know, for an act of good faith, like I said, I think maybe an announcement. If you're going to discontinue the sequels completely and use the veil to reset everything, that maybe you should do that. Just announce it. This is Steph. I'm signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.